So in this section, I'm just going to do some debugging on the pod networking and debugging on the core DNS. So I'll just give you my cluster. I have my cluster up and running, right? So I created namespaces, NS1. I have Nginx pod running in namespace 1. I have a BusyBox 2 running in namespace 2, and I have another one running on namespace 3. So if we see which node they are running, one, two, right? So basically, I only have two nodes, but the whole thing is that one of them is running, like the Nginx is running on one node, while the BusyBox, both of them are running on another worker node. So basically, the pods are on different VMs. So what now, if I exit, and the difference between these pods is that in the BusyBox pods, let me do a pod YAML for you. YAML. So if you look at the YAML file, the only addition I did was I added a namespace and I added a host name. So if you see, it has a label and host name, which is a BusyBox NS2. So I also created a subdomain. So basically, this is, if the host name is not specified, this is an optional field. If the host name is not specified, then the pod name is basically how the DNS will, when you want to resolve it, basically it will take the name of the pod, then it will take the namespace, and then it will do pod.cluster.local. But in this case, so if, for example, if I exec, right, into BusyBox, pod2, minus namespace, NS2, minus SSH, right? And if I do a host name, see that it has a host name. So I added this additional field just because otherwise it can be located via IP address. So I added this field just to test it out. I also want to show what is running in the core DNS. So if I do get pods minus namespace kube system, I have core DNS. My core DNS is running on both minus O wide. So it's running. So if you can see, the core DNS is only running on the master. So as you can see, my core DNS, right? Let me grab for it. My core DNS, only two pods are running, and they are running on master. So they are not running on. And this is how it. I didn't do anything explicitly for this, but most likely the replica was only two, and then both of them are running on the master because I created the master first and then I added the worker nodes one by one, you know, after some time. So the core DNS did not go. So now if my pods are running on the workers and there is no way to route the request between the pods, then if I do an NS lookup from one pod for the other by the host name, it won't work. So let me exec into one of the pods. In NS1, right? So I'm going to exec into it, and I'm going to do NS lookup on the other way, right? So I'll do NS1, right? And my pod name is Nginx dash pod. The other one, which is called BusyBox pod. So if you can see over here, right, it is not able to resolve because, but if you see my hcresolve.com, right, let's check at the resolve.com. So I will do a cat on it. So my hcresolve.com, it has everything set up, right? This is the way it is supposed to be set up, because it should have the information about the search criteria, right? How is it going to search for the different pods in the cluster and the name server. It has to have the name server is basically coming from the node itself. So in I am not able to ping or look up for one pod and the other between within the cluster, right? Which without, so if this was a service and we had a cluster IP or if we had an endpoint, then it's another thing to reach through us via service mesh or through directly to the F5. But if I am just trying to communicate between my two pods within the cluster, it's not working. And one of the reasons for that is my core DNS is not running on the worker nodes, right? Because you see there are only two instances running. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to see if, so I'm going to edit the core DNS deployment. Core DNS, right? So let me get that. And I will look for replica. Let me just change it to 3. Okay, and now let me look for. And I want to see. So it's running on worker 2. So I have. So my core DNS is now running on worker 2. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just delete my busybox 2 and 3 because then I will recreate them because I just have added a new core DNS component in the worker node. Running and I'm going to see if it does. So after enabling the core DNS and then redeploying the pods, I will do a lookup on the, so this is the first check to make sure that it's able to resolve Kubernetes.default. And another thing to check up is the resolve.com if is absolutely fine so that it has. So we can look at the logs. If we see anything out of the ordinary, let's say the new one that the on the worker node, right? Look at the log on that one. This one. So the logs are fine, the plugin is reloaded and it's running. And then let's look at the service. So if I do get SVC minus N cube system, I have. So as you can see, this NS lookup for the IP, right? It specifically gives me where the whole domain of the kube DNS where it's running. And for my pod, specifically is giving the IP. So I'm going to just add the log here to make sure that I am in the config map so that I can grab the logs. And so I got, so I have my endpoints, which is fine. The kube DNS is running fine. And I have the log enabled and it will take a few minutes to propagate that to all the kube DNS parts. So let's check that. Okay, now let me look at the log again. So if you see, there is some more information relating to the logs. It has